Okay, today, just three of us, we are going to do a little bit of sharing on how to build a website using Google Site, which is free. So the good news is it's free. So let's see how to get started.
Okay.
I think a lot of people do not know, this thing exists. Right, so I want to talk about how do we get started. Okay, now the first thing is, of course, we go into something called Google Chrome, right here. So how do we actually go and look for these Google sites? You can't find them inside here one, you know.
Okay.
Tak jumpa punya. Kalau you nak cari pun tak jumpa punya. I don't know why they don't want to put it inside here. Tak jumpa. I cari already tak jumpa. So what you need to do is you need to type here. You go there sites. Sites. Google.com. So that's the starting point.
Sites.
Google.com. Yeah.
Okay.
And as long as you have a Gmail account, you can already use it.
Must have Gmail account.
Because it's a Google product.
Okay. So Google Suite pun boleh lah.
As long as ada kaitan dengan Google lah. You got your Gmail. Just like your Google Classroom, kalau you tak ada Gmail, susah sikit nak masuk kan? Same lah, same idea here lah.
So you come out this screen?
You come out this way. Maybe I want, you share your screen?
I share my screen. Okay.
Because my one sudah ada kan, you baru nak start kan? So you pergi Google.
Okay, I go Google. Okay, and then I go to just now you say once. Okay, sites.google.com. Enter.
That's it.
Okay.
Click.
Click this one. Okay.
Dah. Yeah, you start. Right. You start already.
Free. Okay. So I start free trial, is it or what?
Actually, I tak pernah. Ini adalah workplace tau. Sites at doodle.com. Kenapa?
Ah, that's why I tengok tadi. Sama ke different? Different kot.
Tak sama. Ini.
You kena I tepi ni kat tepi tu. Mana site tu? Ada Google site tu. Google site. Oh ni eh, yang ni eh. Cuba tengok situ ha. Yep. Cuba.
Yang
sorry.
Bukan yang tadi tu. Sebab saya punya dah lama saya ada ni tau. So I pun tak tahu lupa mula saya mula tu macam mana.
Okay.
Lupa daratan. Okay.
Okay, you tengok di atas sekali dia ada portfolio, dia ada event, itu adalah dia punya tank gallery tau.
Okay.
Kalau you guna gallery dia, lepas tu you tukar dia punya content pun cepat habis kerja tu.
Okay. Okay. So itu gallery, so you can use it as a sample lah.
Ada sample lah, you boleh explore ke sana lah. Tapi kali ini kita tak guna sample lah, you explore this yourself lah, the gallery. Okay. We click the plus symbol.
Okay, click the plus symbol, blank.
Blank.
Yes. All right, clicking.
So the first thing you get is that.
Okay, so I skip.
Betul lah, skip.
Skip, all right.
Okay, so all you look up there, there's something called untitled site kan?
Yes.
So what do you want this site to be used for?
Let's say, just put down there,
what is your branding, Uni?
My branding. Example, can you just define branding? What you mean by branding?
How do you want people to call you? Your brand?
I call,
Macam Suhaila, she want people to call her Teacher Su.
Oh.
How do you call yourself?
I call myself. I always call myself.
Juni.
They call me Uni.
Uni apa? Uni garden.
You tahu tak kenapa saya tanya you? Sebab nanti kalau you dah siap, sebab it automatically save. Then when you book, you see their Uni.
They always call me Puan Uni.
Uni lah. Just put Uni lah. Uni Puan.
Boleh lah.
Don't let people know you are so old.
I am already what I mean lah. Okay.
All right. Now, this is your first page. The only page lah so far, kan? Kalau you pergi ke sebelah kiri, kanan, you akan nampak insert pages and team.
Insert pages and team. Oh, kat sini je. I cannot move. I punya I gambar. I,
okay, nampak tak? Insert.
Insert, okay. Pages, page, team. So, team. So what should I do?
Now, wait lah. We explain to you the interface.
Oh, oh, okay.
Now, insert ni adalah dia punya kandungan yang kamu nak masuk. So, we will come, most of our discussion here is around this area lah. So, let's go to the another one, pages.
Pages.
So, mm-hmm. So far you will see there's only one page.
Yes.
Sudah tekan ke?
Tekan eh? Okay. Document successfully. Tekan.
Tengok dia ada home sahaja kan?
Betul.
Kalau you nak tambah muka surat, the second page, the third page and so on, then there's a plus symbol in the middle. So you won't miss
one. Oh, this one. Okay. Yeah, new link, new page.
So click new page lah. Okay. Click sahaja lah. Then you put there my profile or profile. Something like that.
Elvin, yang tadi uni letak uni tu, tu kira that should be your page lah.
Your home page lah. So your then you put size.google, then uni.
Uni. Okay.
So when you click your home kan, you click your home. Tak di sebelah kanan tu home.
Kanan. Yeah, the home here. So here's profile, here's home.
The one on the right hand side where you click.
Oh, okay. 1 minute.
Di hujungnya.
Okay.
Ada tiga dot tu kan?
Yes. Yes.
Go into the properties ah.
Okay.
Di sinilah dia nama yang kamu nak tunjuk semasa mereka ada site tu. Right, so sites.google.com, lepas tu ada nama you lah. So, okay. Kalau you nak uni, letak uni. Kalau you nak ke perkataan home, dia akan pergi ke home. Ini adalah nama akan keluar dalam site kamu nanti.
Let's say like that lah.
Like that.
Okay.
So, this is the home page of your... People say landing page lah. You can call it page
pun lah. Okay.
So that whenever you give people, you jangan bagi site ni, tapi you bagi link sahaja. Satu button, click, that's your landing page. You come here.
Oh, landing page. Okay.
Boleh jugalah, suka hati you. Lepas tu di sebelah kanannya ada team.
Team, yes.
Dalam team ni, you boleh pilih lah. Ada Aristotle, ada diplomat, level.
Oh, impression. Contoh, okay, let's say diplomat.
Ini you macam.
Tulisan dia
Warna tu you pilih lah, warna apa.
Oh, gitu.
Warna banyak ke? Itu je.
Banyak.
Ya, warna you pilih lah. Now, team ni maksudnya dia punya font, dia punya design, macam itulah.
Okay.
So, it's really up to you to choose the team lah.
Okay.
So, katakan you pilih impression, dia akan tukar jadi semua page kamu akan tukar jadi impression lah. Okay. So if you diplomat, then diplomat lah.
Okay. Example.
In the font style dan sebagainya, color. Really up to you lah.
Okay. Got it.
So ini tiga perkara saja, tak ada apa pun lagi kat sini. Itu je.
So the page title is like, what's my program name? Is it something like
that? The page is about what?
Dia macam website, macam website yang ada yang macam you punya tab je lah kan?
Sebenarnya, you boleh bagi nama ataupun you boleh buang. You don't have to give pun. Tak semestinya ada teks. You nak letak gambar saja pun boleh.
Okay. So how do I put just picture?
Okay.
I just...
So let's go into putting in some pictures. Now, whatever that you are looking at here is called the header, your banner lah, your banner or your header. Kalau you tengok di bawah tu ada change image dan header type.
Yes.
Header type, click.
Dia ada header type.
Dia large banner.
Yes. Yes.
They are cover. Cover page paling besar lah.
Cover deh, cover. I went to cover already, so you went bigger.
Paling besar lah kalau you nak letak gambar saja. Bila masuk saja nampak gambar you ni.
Gitu.
Kalau saya selalu guna banner lah, kecil punya lah.
Kecil, okay. Yalah, small will do.
So done.
I click inside. Then
you go to the image.
Change image lah. Upload is it?
Kena upload lah.
Okay, let me just quickly choose. Ha. Jangan gelak tau. Gambar-gambar ni. Boleh letak ni dululah.
Boleh juga.
Oh, macam tu pula dia jadi background eh.
Dia akan, dia tak akan besarkan kawasan tapi picture tu akan fit. Ini adalah dia punya masalah lah. You have to go and find how to do it lah. Okay, now you tengok gambar ni macam very grey kan? Okay, you nampak tak di hujung sebelah kanan bawah tu ada bintang-bintang tu? You letak dalam, you put yang mana? You nampak tak?
Okay, bintang yes.
You click remove ke? So they grey out or something lah. Kalau you nak solid, then can. You can remove the text if you don't want.
I see. So also I can remove this text. So how do I remove? I just delete off, is it?
Yeah.
Let's say I delete off.
Saya pun tak pernah delete lah, tapi boleh.
But I think can.
So atas tu.
Understand lah.
So you're saying that picture, how I'm going to crop it over, I have to find a way lah.
You have to use like PowerPoint or whatever lah.
If I use cover, then maybe besar sikit. Banner besar sikit, but when the banner becomes small, large banner nampak besar lah kan?
Dia punya gambar dia akan terus fit. Dia tak akan, tak ada option lain tau. Ini dia.
Oh, okay. Faham.
Dia tak seperti some of the software you can like fit to the proportion dan sebagainya. Tak ada tau. Dia itu saja.
Nasib lah kalau gambar itu besar sikit, nasib lah.
If you know your picture, if you know your banner is long lah, rectangle kan, you janganlah cari gambar yang square.
Okay, understood. Okay,
now change image.
Change image, upload again is it?
You pilih yang grey colour tu, di sebelah dia.
Wait.
Grey colour.
You asking this one lah?
No. Change image tadi betul.
Change image betul.
Upload. There's one picture there called IMG20191. Oh, you nak itu? Nak itu pun boleh?
Zoom. Ini, this one.
So, like that lah.
Okay. Kalau banner, this is my banner. This is, I use banner now.
Yeah lah. Understand kan?
Jadi, faham.
Sebelum kamu masukkan ke dalam sini, you tengok kawasan yang dia ada, you can open up your PowerPoint. Lepas tu you letaklah perkataan yang kamu nak letak di sini, then you save it as a picture.
Okay, understood.
Then when you put it in again, dia cantik lah.
Understood. Okay.
So this one is not the content tau. Ini cuma, it's just like your decoration at the top only lah.
Let me see if it's a fit. This one is that I have to adjust, so if not it will clash with mine. Kan?
Kena adjust lah. You kena masukkan dulu, tengok mana dia.
Yeah.
You tahu, you take a photo, you know where you want to add the text and so on. How do you bring it down? All this kind of thing lah.
Yeah, betul. Correct. That means it has to, like, okay, tak apa, I reset balik. Okay, understood.
Okay. So that is just a banner. It's just a banner. Kalau you rasa susah lah, leceh lah, tak maulah semua gambar-gambar ni, header type, just choose title only.
Header type, title only. So, and then?
Tapi title tu you dah buang tadi kan?
You tahu? So, I have to key balik.
So let's go to insert.
So insert.
Text box.
Okay.
Kita tarik ke atas. Cuba.
Tarik ke atas kejap.
Okay. Itu je.
Okay. Then everything, you type whatever.
Everything is stretchable tau. Itu yang best tu.
Tapi
dia dalam kekangan dalam kawasan tu sahajalah. So you see the thing called normal text.
Yes.
You can change it to heading, title. Dia akan besar.
But I cannot use the themes anymore, right? Because I deleted the themes just now, right?
No, it's still in the themes. It's just that you didn't put picture ni.
Okay. Understood. Okay.
You dah ganti gambar, lepas tu you buang gambar tu. Dah tak ada. Okay, so sometimes when you design, you tak nak letak dia punya, you tak nak letak dia punya gambar dan sebagainya, you nak tajuk sahaja di atas. For example, you are doing managing your EQ. You letaklah tajuk tu saja.
Okay. So let's say
supervisory
example lah, simple lah.
Macam tu. Itu sajalah. Okay. So if you want to put picture, then you add picture lah.
Okay, understood.
Okay, sekarang kita nak tambah sesuatu di bawah ni. Di bawah tajuk ni kan. So you go to insert.
I go to insert.
Di bawah ni tengok layout.
Okay.
Nah, dia ada predefined layout yang kamu boleh guna. Jadi you tengok yang pertama tu ada gambar, lepas tu ada teks di tepi. Lepas tu ada dua gambar, teks di bawah. If you only one gambar, tak mau teks, you pilih yang ketiga. Ha, itu je. Dah masuk dah.
So, for the program, I put picture here, I edit text here.
Yeah.
So itu here, je. You add your own form for let's say upload lah. I just buat contoh je lah kan.
Tadi lah ya, gambar tu. Gambar you pakai mask tu ha.
Oh, ni ni, anak perempuan lah. Boleh je lah. Marah dia.
Dah masuk dah. Okay.
So,
Chop. You click that box, the picture box. Click, you boleh tarik ke bawah. Tengok, tak, handle dia, handle. You click, nampak tak ada handle. Click dulu.
Handle.
You click sahaja gambar tu.
Okay.
Click, don't move. Just click ni.
Okay.
You tengok blue handle, you tarik.
Okay.
Nampak? Sebab gambar kamu kan panjang tadi.
Oh, iyalah.
Macam ni lah.
Okay.
You see on top there, atas tu ada crop, ada feed, ada link.
Ada crop, ada uncrop, ada insert link, ada delete. Okay, then so ada alternate text.
You pergi ke uncrop tu.
Uncrop.
Nah, dia akan fit the picture inside.
Okay.
Tapi artinya you tak crop lah.
Uncrop ready. Done.
So you can click on her. So anybody who click your picture, it will link to somewhere.
Oh, I see. Okay.
You tak payah letak link ke?
Tekan link. Lepas tu you boleh bagi dia link to where? Link to the profile in this site.
So link means
ataupun you boleh pergi ke let's say a YouTube site. Her YouTube channel. Then automatically you will go to that page called the YouTube channel there lah.
Okay, macam kalau you nak buat link to FB ke pun boleh jugalah kan?
You kena copy the link here lah.
Okay, understood. Okay, copy the link. Alright.
Okay, so then you have your text. Then you put in the text, the title. And you continue lah, you build your own landing page lah. Okay, you dah, okay.
Betul lah.
Now you realize that the font is too big kan?
Yes.
I like you tukar. Yang ini semua I rasa is self-explanatory lah. You boleh.
Yeah. Alright. Yeah, edit text and you type anything that you want lah.
You click dulu. Okay. Now what is interesting here is that you can actually change the bullets and everything. But dia tak dapat control macam Microsoft Word.
Okay. But so, at least have the basic lah.
Yes, at least you have the basic. And then you have the normal text. Normal text tu you boleh nampak ada banyak lagi pilihan. Katakan you ada subtext dan sebagainya. Boleh.
Subtext apa tu?
Contohlah.
Okay, you pergi ke you click dulu. Click dulu dalam salah satunya. Lepas tu you pergi ke tepi kan ada normal text tu.
Okay.
Normal text. Now you click kan? You akan nampak you serupa tak dengan. Jadi katakan ini adalah subheading. You upgrade dia menjadi subheading.
Okay.
Kan you punya course ada tajuk besar, lepas tu ada subheading dia and content.
Macam table of content.
Apa yang dia bagi, dia cuma bagi dua text box sahaja. Betul? Sekarang kamu nak tambah sebab you ada subheading, lepas tu you barulah text, barulah dia punya content. Then you have to click up there called text box on the right.
Text box on the right, okay. I click mana-mana
Click.
Just click?
Click sahaja, lepas tu tarik dia ke dalam.
Tarik dia ke dalam?
Macam tu, lepas. Then you see the text box already.
Why
I tell you this is because at the beginning, bila saya buat, macam mana dia bagi dua kotak saja? Saya nak tambah lagi macam mana? Saya pun nak figure out. So, but after that, can move anywhere I want. So it's quite flexible lah in a way.
I see. Okay. Understood. Text box. Okay. And then the layouts. Yeah. Alright. Okay. So image is, if you want to add more image.
You want to put another image somewhere. So you just click, then it will come out on.
I click.
You pergi bawah sekali.
Wait. Here. I go there.
No. Then you try to click the image.
Image. They ask to upload.
Ah, Katakan so, report
select. Cincai dulu lah. Cincai dulu lah. Kita letak, testing. Oops.
Dah masuk lah.
Oh, dia di, oh, dia di atas. So, I can pull down.
Tarik sajalah.
Tarik sajalah.
Nampak?
Oh, nice. Nice. Huh?
Okay.
You know what I'm trying to tell you lah. It's like, it's very flexible. You, know? You tarik sajalah kat mana-mana. Asalkan you bahagia.
I see. Testing yang tengah testing.
Okay. Sekarang, sekarang kita tengok Fina pula buat. Boleh?
Boleh.
Okay, Fina. Okay, I.
You cuba-cuba. Sekarang Fina pula cuba.
I stop share. Okay? Hold on. Okay. So Kelvin, another question ah, it's not that one tak payah save punya kan? We do no need, there's no save, nothing, everything no need, right?
Yeah, auto save.
Auto save. So if I want to override, can override anytime?
Can. You just go in, just change only lah.
So I can recycle that page anytime I want lah.
Itu tekan remove itu je.
Oh.
Kat luar tu bila you click remove lah.
Okay.
You want the duplicate, you duplicate lah.
Oh, I see. Okay, understood. Okay, so Fina punya turn.
Oh, I belum log in. No wonder lah. I belum log in. Aduh, hari ni tak buka lagi. Apa Gmail?
You know your password.
Your password?
Tu bawah tu tekan je lah.
Tak, different.
Okay, Uni, we know her password already.
Ayo.
Tak klik show password. Mana boleh.
Don't scare her lah.
Apa password ayo?
Ayo.
Aduh, I kan kalau rasa kalau kata
I got one book here.
Tukar apa?
I got one book here just for password lah. The password here. Sudah tua tak boleh ingat password oh.
Click no thanks.
I have 2-step verification tau.
Amboi.
Lepas tu kalau tiba-tiba apa bateri kong mampus. Alright, so you kata tadi boleh kita start.
So, nanti Fina, I you cuba pula guna yang
template. Okay. I guna template. Let's see.
Tengok atas tu template gallery ada up and down arrow dan sebagainya kan?
Tengok apa ada.
Banyak tu.
Wow.
Event.
Banyak. Holiday party. Her dog walker pun ada. Saloon.
Okay. Katakanlah kita ambil project lah. Oh, event ke? Portfolio lah.
Boleh je. The step is the same. It's just that now it has been predefined for you. Itu je.
Cantik sikit lah.
Dia sebab mula-mula you buat, you tak ada idea.
Yep.
You just go and steal other people's template. Lepas tu tukar je lah. Dia ada 3 buka surat. Home, about, project page. Kalau you pergi pages, saya nampak ada 3.
Okay, so hi, I am
Fina.
Fina, great.
Coach, or facilitator.
AGM producer,
A virtual producer.
Yeah.
Sombong. From
the Earth, Mother Earth.
From the virtual world, Jay.
From the virtual world.
Wow, seriously. Sounds so 3D, 4D, yeah?
Okay. So, my name here. Alright. Then, lepas tu. Sebab dia dah siap kan yang semua dah kan?
Kan.
Gambar boleh tukar kan? Gambar.
You just have to fit in the information je.
Just now the picture can change tak?
Boleh.
Can kot rasanya.
Tina, tukarlah gambar lawa-lawa tu. Tina.
You go to the three dot.
Three dot.
Okay, sekejap.
you click again, three dot two, then change, then, replace image.
Okay, katakanlah I apa upload tapi I nak search. Dia kena dalam komputer juga ke ataupun I boleh search from
you,
other places?
You select.
Okay, let's say kita select.
If you select, dia rasa dia akan pergi your Google Drive ke?
Itulah Google Drive. Tak,
dia boleh search.
Search by Google Image Search. Okay. Google Image Set. Okay.
Tak pernah pakai ni.
Virtual reality. Jadi.
Wow.
Okay, so let's go.
Mana yang tumbuk tu?
Back. Alright, insert. Okay. So that. I boleh bagi kecil kan kalau I mahu kan?
Boleh. Kecilkan dia.
Nice.
Okay, you see the grid line? The grid line is your only place you can move around lah. You tak boleh overlap punya.
Okay. Oh.
Okay, then you see your text ah. You click on your text. Sekarang you ini size dia kan? Itu je. Dia akan ikut dia punya grid line tu saja.
Oh, I see.
It's not freely you can move anywhere.
Okay.
Ini pun boleh tarik. Nampak dia ada grid line dia.
Okay. Alright. So now dia ada kat bawah ni dah selected work. So ini kalau you nampak cepat is good lah kan?
Ini pada mulanya bila saya start ni kan, saya pun guna template saja. I'm learning what they are doing mah. I pun tak tahu apa yang dia boleh buat. So I was trying lah because Nazrin tak ajar. Dia cuma tunjuk je.
Presentation tu you pergi insert yours kan?
Apa dia?
Tu yang Afina klik presentation kan tadi?
I cuma klik ni je. Sebabnya let's say
kalau maksud dia keluar you punya semua, you punya slides.
Okay, you pergi ke bawah Afina. You scroll down on the right hand side kan layout kan, you scroll down lagi, scroll down you nampak tak, these are all the thing, the presentation is called slide. Jadi bila kamu klik saja dia akan keluar, lepas tu name of project, ini adalah image, lepas tu ini adalah video. Tengok dia, kalau you pergi bawah you tengok ada YouTube lah.
Sebab yang ni rasanya dia ambil kita punya slides, whatever slide yang kita ada.
PowerPoint slides.
So dia baca automatic daripada you punya Google lah.
So and then ini you type image, they select image. So let's say kalau kata.
So if you put everything in your Google what you call that? Your Google Drive kan? So easy for you to find your thing on.
What if we did not put in Google Drive? So how do we insert?
Eventually it will be in your Google Drive. Whatever that you put inside this site, everything is inside your Google Drive.
But let's say my slides that is not in the Google Drive because I save in.
Selepas kamu letak di sini, dia akan masuk ke Google Drive.
Oh, so I cannot take from the thumb drive.
Can. Tapi selepas you masuk sahaja. Bila you masuk saja dalam site ni, a copy of it will be inside your Google Drive.
Okay.
So let's see what else we can we do. Masukkan YouTube.
Masuk sajalah apa tu. I cheated. Proposed to my girlfriend. Apa? Video pun sudah masuk.
So maksudnya satu page ni satu item ke atau what was the best way? Maksudnya kalau macam kita nak gunakan ni sebagai macam kita punya material repository ni, satu page satu benda ke macam mana?
You boleh buat satu module satu page.
So mudahlah sikit sebabnya everything inside there kan.
Katakan you ajar module ni hari ini. Selepas mereka attend your class, barulah kamu turn on the second module. You dah siap tapi you are not showing it. Okay, let me show you how you do it. Huh? You go to pages on your right hand side.
Okay.
You tekan pages.
Kan? Pages ni. Okay.
Dah. Sekarang you kat home. Okay, katakan home itu adalah module 1. Selepas dia habis module 1, baru you nak buka about. So you go to about. You pergi ke 3 dot tu. Okay, you tengok hide from navigation.
Oh, okay.
Nobody can see tau.
Bila dia masuk ke site kamu,
dia pun tak nampak module 2. Tapi selepas dia habis module 2, baru you turn on show from in navigation. Tuk, dia akan keluar.
Sub-page ni, apa dia you?
Huh?
At sub-page ni?
This page, you have a sub-page. It's not a page by itself. Dia akan module 1. Module 1 terlalu banyak content kan. So you can actually like click, dia akan pergi ke sub-page. Tapi masih dalam module 1.
So let's say tadi kita kat home tadi ada macam-macam so then I decided to add sub page.
Okay.
Apa jadi ya?
You letak
okay. So kata
introduction.
My sub home.
My sub home.
Okay.
Macam bunyi subway tadi. My subway.
Dan so apa yang keluar?
Nampak dia ada indentation kan? So it will not appear in your home, but when you click the home, there's a drop down list. You tengok atas tu.
Click home.
Okay.
Understood. That's how people actually do their write up in the Google when you check that title, then they go down.
Then dia kata my courses.
Yes.
Ada banyak jenis courses.
Correct.
So that's the page macam tu lah.
So one. Kita boleh dia ada limitation tak berapa banyak sub page kita boleh add on?
I don't know. Itu saya rasa tak ada ke. As long as you still have your Google Drive punya the space lah.
Oh, so dia still take up you punya Google Drive punya space jugaklah.
Memang. Habis they do it free for you ah, do you think?
Yes. That's why they want us to add on money to buy more space, right?
Tapi tak, actually tak mahal tau kalau macam apa? Tengok kan dia punya tu not really
expensive. Setahun tak. Baru berapa ringgit saja.
Itulah, and then you have 100 giga ke apa
ke? Sampai sekarang baru 30 lebih persen saja.
How much is it? Oh, 100 plus
ke? If I'm not mistaken, it's 80 or something like that.
80 ringgit Malaysia.
Satu bulan saya rasa 8 ringgit ke macam mana? Something like that.
Okay.
Very affordable. Okay. It's not expensive.
Apa beza ni project page ni?
You don't have anything yet mah. So you click lah pergi project page. Tengok. There's nothing there lah.
Two sentence or this. Oh.
Dia adalah page yang lain lah. So if you see a lot of people design landing page kan. Dia punya program the landing page kan. So landing page is not supposed to have menu lah. Betul tak? It's one page, you scroll all the way down, in the middle you nak mereka sign up, then all those things lah you boleh buat. So kalau kamu pergi ke insert, you akan nampak ada satu, one of the thing that you can insert is Google Form di bawah, form right, nampak right. So bila you click sana, dia akan masuk Google Form ke dalam, you akan pilih lah Google Form kamu.
Okay, yang mana yang kita dah siap buat lah maksudnya.
Tu, dimasukkan ke dalam sini, dia klik sajalah, dia akan masukkan maklumat lah. Sign up. Something ada lah. Nampak? So you're going to make this form inside your site. Terus dia boleh buat. Ataupun you can do something like button. Can you see up there, button?
That's what I was tanya. Button kat mana?
Atas sikit. Zoom pula. Scroll atas sikit. Tak. Dalam insert tu.
Okay. Oh, here. Button.
Click.
Okay. Then kita letak link je lah. Okay. I baru nak tanya tadi. Okay. Let's see. I letak ada
quiz. Click dalam link tu tengok.
Quiz. Lepas tu link dia. Dia ambil kat mana?
You type lah. You kena pergi cari link tu. Yang ini adalah in this website. dia tak tahu mana you nak cari mah. You kena tahu lah you punya, you go to your Google Drive, you ambil you punya form punya link tu, you copy and paste je lah.
Okay. So let's see kalau I letak kita punya apa, tiny.cc tu je lah. Okay.
Hey, kalau you nak cuba, tak boleh cuba kat sini. You kena publish.
Oh, okay.
Atas tu, tekan tu, publish.
Once kita dah siap semua ke? Oh, boleh publish ke apa?
Oh, kat atas kanan.
Boleh
kanan
juga. Tak ada orang tahu you punya link mah. So, nobody will be able to see. So, you click lah. You click the word publish on the right hand side.
Tu, oh, atas sebelah gambar Fina.
So, dia nama dia Fina Arif lah.
Okay.
Lah. Lepas tu pergi ke dia punya anak panah di tepi publish tu.
Okay.
Klik, then you choose view publish site. Dia akan buka di sebelah. Ini adalah you punya site lah.
Okay, so let's see if I click here, that will happen.
Redirecting.
You know what I'm trying to tell you, right?
Yeah.
Tutup ni. You go there, you see got home kan? Home, atas tu. You click home. Dia akan pergi ke home. So you can simulate your page lah.
Menarik. Actually kalau macam let's say apa, as kita punya portfolio kan, it's very very good lah. Apa letak apa saja projek yang kita ada kan. So at least people, rather than kita nak bercerita macam-macam, so at least people can just take a look of this sahajalah.
Betul. Jadi so, apa yang Nazrin nasihatkan kita dalam breakaway punya training class tu, to design something so that the training provider or your client, whenever they request for something, you can give them information just like that. How? You build your site. Jadi dia minta Fina bagi training on top management virtual meeting. So you ada satu site yang kamu telah sediakan. You copy and paste the site name sahaja kepada dia. Klik, dia sudah dapat maklumat.
Jadi, yang page tu lah kita bagi, yang that page yang because kita boleh bagi dia only specific page sahaja kan, link or to the specific page sahaja kan.
Suka hati you lah. So if you want to give your training, your trainer profile, katakan you buat satu site just for your trainer profile, then you do another site just for program A, you do another site just for program B. Bila dia tanya tentang program B, you hantar sajalah program B.
Maksudnya kita ada banyak site. Kita banyak site ke? Banyak site lah.
Banyak site lah. Lepas tu you build one site that connects to all.
Okay, how do you go about with that?
That means the link lah. You that the link, connect the link lah.
So from kata daripada home ni ke? Dari sini ni. So kita type the link dekat
itu mana? Itu is optional lah. You want or don't want lah. Tapi kalau you nak bagi course outline, so there's one web page yang site yang kamu buat ada course outline. Jadi bila trainer provider tanya tentang course outline tu, you bagi dia ini. Lepas tu ada satu button di bawah, klik download course outline. Dia sudah baca, dia nak download course outline. Mana letaknya file tu? It's a Word document in your Google Drive. Jadi you tak perlu berinteraksi dengan dia. Dia boleh baca terus dari sini. Lepas tu dia boleh download kalau dia nak. Dia tak perlu download dulu baru baca.
Okay, faham.
So it's a convenient you can give client. Right? Now, Fina, you balik semula ke one tab, the second one. This one is your publish site mah. One tab. Di atas your tab atas.
Oh, okay.
Kan Fina Arif yang ketiga, tab yang ketiga tu.
Tab yang ketiga.
Di sebelah post attendee Zoom tu.
Post attending Zoom.
You ada WhatsApp, lepas tu post attendee Zoom. Ah. You ada the third tab, Fina Arif. You go back to your edit.
Ah, okay, sekejap dah. I want to go dulu. Okay.
Ah, tu. Now, bila you balik ke sini, this is where you design lah kan. Ini adalah design kamu lah. So, you always back and forth the other side to see lah. Kalau you tak mau, you boleh tutup, you boleh publish again. So that's how you move about lah.
Kevin, that means just now she published, and then when she go back and change something, she has to republish again.
Republish and then view again.
Or else that the first one she published should stay there.
Yes. Now, Fina, I want you to do this. You see the button publish tadi kan?
Yep.
Sebelum tu ada tiga dot.
After.
Sebelum tu ada gear.
After.
Sebab tu ada orang dengan plus.
After.
I want you to go two more button. There's something got a picture of a computer, your phone dan sebagainya. It's button called preview. Click preview tu. Apa terjadi ya?
Ni baru dia keluar ke sini. Ni je previewnya.
Preview macam tadi kan? You ada tiga pilihan di sini. Laptop, tab atau phone.
Oh. If you click phone, what happen?
Click lah. Cubalah.
Ah, ni rupa dia.
Ini adalah
phone. This is how people see it in the dream phone lah.
Tablet, bila you design, you also have to think of the GUI, the user interface.
I see. Oh, that's interesting. Oh, by the way, Kevin, she published just now. Can she unpublish? There's no such thing called unpublish, right?
Just delete lah.
Yeah?
Just delete the site lah.
Delete the site.
So, maksudnya kira tak boleh unpublish lah.
Oh, you balik semula? Okay, you click the X.
Click the X.
Okay. Tengok ada tak unpublish? Aku tak tahu. Tengok tu. Pergi drop down.
Drop down.
Publish drop down tu.
Unpublish dia dah.
Ah, tu ada.
Cuba klik. Just klik.
The unpublished.
Yes, no longer you still can make edits.
Oh, got it. Yes.
The website no longer live lah. I tak pernah buat ni lah.
Okay. That's good. That's a good one.
Okay. So unpublished.
One good thing to have in your site, if you have lah, if you're gonna build, is your footnote. Bawah sekali. Okay. Double click di bawah sekali itu. Kan add footnote. Tak? Add footnote, nampak tak? Di tengah-tengah. Okay, go up a bit your mouse.
Yes. Add footer.
Ini okay. Letak your copyright statement lah, trademark lah dan sebagainya.
Copyright.
Reserve 2021.
Copyright and protected. 2021 and beyond.
Apa itu? So this is a copyright. So every page akan ada. Tak perlu you buat semula.
Alright. So macam mana I nak buat ni? Macam mana I nak keluar balik dari sini?
Ha?
Hold on lah. Sebab dia...
Just click on ni
lah. Okay.
Jadi kalau you pergi ke setiap muka surat, you akan nampak footnote ni ke bawah.
Okay.
Footnote pula. Footer.
Footer. Okay. So let's see if I go to about. Pun ada.
Okay. Now, look ah. Your menu is at the top kan?
Yep.
Home, about, project page is at the top. Betul? Sekarang saya nak kamu pergi lihat di sebelah kiri ada satu gear.
Yep.
Click. So you can decide where you want to put it. So it says there top. Itu sebabnya you punya menu ada ke atas.
So kalau kata side.
Side. Dia akan berada di sebelah.
Okay.
Di sini kamu boleh buat you punya brand image, boleh logo kamu, your favorite icon, all this lah.
Logo. So let's
Oh. Upload. Cari mana itu ada gambar. Oh, tak ada pula ni. OneDrive pada dah tak jumpa. Cek. Okey.
Apa itu cok ni?
Lepas tu Fabricon ni benda?
Upload dia lah.
Oh. Fabricon. Benda Fabricon.
Icon. Letaklah muka you.
Muka I yang comel. Oh boleh. No problem. Jadi lah, lepas tu dan kita go close saja.
Pergi bawah tu tu betul-betul close saja.
Close saja kot. Let's see what happen. So you ada satu tu.
Yang sebelah Fina Arif sudah ada logo tadilah.
Wah, ini ada dah. Tapi nak tengok yang favicon dari tu apa jadi?
Tak ada, tak nampak. You publish dulu.
So let's publish dulu dan tengok apa jadi ya.
Tadi dah unpublish dah.
Yalah, kita publish boleh lah. Dia tak kata pun tak boleh publish dan publish banyak kali. Okay, view. Saya nak tengok apa jadi kat favicon tu kan? Ha?
Tak nampak kan? Saya dah cuba banyak kali, tak nampak juga.
So apa benda dia letak favicon tu?
Saya tak nak beritahu you sebab saya tak jumpa pun. So you notice that is on the left hand side ada ada menu. Dia bukan kat atas dah.
Betul.
Okay, now if you go back, you preview using your phone, that is where it's going to be very confusing.
Okay, let's see. Now kita tengok dekat
ada lah muka you. You tengok atas tu?
Mana? Atas mana?
Nah, Arif, your tab. Your browser punya tab.
Oh, betul.
Rupa.
So that's favicon. Okay, kejap.
I see.
Favicon is for that.
Okay.
Yang writing down.
Alright, so kalau macam you nak
so I pun delete. Baru nampak muka you. Okay.
Okay. So kalau tak nak, kita letak logo biasa je lah, kan?
Betul.
Logo company je lah.
Betul.
Alright. How do we get there just now?
You close lah. This one is your preview, ma.
Oh, okay.
Now let's go to the gearbox again.
Pergi preview atas tu. Preview.
Gearbox.
Tak. Pergi preview atas tu dulu.
Bukan. I nak apa brand image tadi tu. Sebab kan now kita know dia untuk apa dah. So maybe kita upload the logo lah. Let's see.
BLC. BLC logo.
Si logo tak mahu lah. Aku logo I je lah. Company logo. Okay.
Ini logo buang.
Ni bawa logo marketing.
Boleh lah. Dua-dua pun letak sama lah.
So and then bila kita publish, we'll see what happen lah. Then bila kita publish, bolehkah kalau kita
publish tu? View publish tak?
You kena publish dulu rasanya.
Ada publish
tu? You kena publish dulu.
Kena publish dulu.
Publish. Okay.
Kalau dia kata tak ada changes, then okay.
Sorry. So. Publish with confidence. Ambil pula kolom ni.
Okay. Alright. So then.
Publish. Sebelah kanan atas tu, publish.
Tadi bukan publish lah. So dia marah lah sebab asyik publish je.
Yes. Now okay. You view lah.
View.
You can drop down tu.
So drop down to view. View publish tak?
View publish tak?
Ada dah.
Betul. Right. Okay, so
yes.
So at least kalau macam let's say this is your of apa so-called company punya ke, then it's a be a good one lah. So people okay, this is the one. Alright. Okay, now we know what is the favicon.
Nak tengok handphone punya.
What I want to show you is that preview just now ah, yang ada phone, ada tab punya.
Tengok. Kat sini.
Okay, handphone.
For, okay, so for computer, you see on the left lah kan?
Handphone is like this.
Tak ada.
Oh, tak ada, dia stop atas
line
dia.
At the top. The three line at the top. Kalau orang tak tahu guna.
Oh, pengsan. Kalau handphone, payahlah.
Yalah, for handphone and all, kalau dia tengok, dia kena tahu macam mana nak navigate. Di atas tu, klik. Klik. Then you
click. Oh,
the side lah.
The side.
So top is better lah. Because top, if in handphone, they can
tak
see
tak. Me. Maksud saya, you guna mana satu pun, kalau adalah phone ataupun tab, tablet, dia memang macam ni. Tak nampak di atas. Cuma, cuma apa?
Computer je.
Computer sahaja.
Dia akan nampak
computer sahaja side. Akan nampak ketara. On the left or at the top. You boleh cuba sekali lagi, you letak semula dalam top tu. Lepas tu you balik ke telefon, you pun nak nampak juga.
Yeah, I think so, yeah, just not.
Go up lah, go up. Go up. Okay.
Kita kata
top.
Change back.
Okay. So now, if let's say kita go to this one here.
Tengok menu ke atas kan? Kalau phone?
Sama.
Dia tak ada menu ke atas.
Tak ada beza pun. Dia still on the side ke?
But I just want to tell you that only computer are the beza.
Okay, understood. So, preview. Menu bar.
Jadi sebenarnya bila kamu buat sedikit perubahan, tak payah pamit dulu. Pergi ke preview ni, tengok kalau semua dah okay, dah siap, dah puas hati, baru you publish.
Okay.
Phone will need to drag.
Okay, now let's go something a little bit more interactive.
Okay.
I'm going to stop your share for a while. Okay. Now, saya pula yang share.
Share lah. You punya yang canggih.
Tak adalah. Mana ada canggih?
I stalk you punya cakap. Google Kelvin Ng.
Tak adalah.
Dia ada dia punya apa. You pakai apa? CEM Designal ke apa ke?
Betul.
So, adalah dia punya apa. All those course outline.
Sekejap, I tukar dia punya setting sikit. So this is my site lah. Yang saya. Okay, so
hal tu, yang bawah tu penuh.
All this you need.
Oh, cantik.
You kena letak. You kena siapkan dulu dalam PowerPoint.
Okay.
Apa yang saya buat ialah saya selalu siapkan semua dalam PowerPoint. So, let me just go to my PowerPoint file. Mana saya letak? Okay. It's inside here.
Banyaknya barang dia.
Very organized.
Yalah.
Saya kena nak cari mampus.
Sama.
So, this is the PowerPoint file that I used to design for the site.
So you buat siap-siap semua dalam PowerPoint dulu.
Yang gambar-gambar yang kamu nampak dalam site tu semuanya dekat sini. Yok, I design semua tu dekat sini dulu.
Okay.
So all this, if you see all those logo and so on kan, semuanya ada dekat sini. I was doing it from here.
Okay.
So, VLC. All those things lah. Jadi you kena sediakan satu tempat untuk design all your stuff lah. You have to do this. So once you katakan you nak ambil yang ini, so you can select this one and this one. Okay, then you right click, save as picture. Then you load it into your website.
Jadi maksudnya kita prepare siap-siap, dia tak payahlah cari macam nak gila
You don't go and do screen print screen dan sebagainya tau, jangan. Jadi you buat kat sini, you boleh highlight apa yang kamu nak di sini. Dan pastikan dia tak keluar daripada tak keluar daripada kotak ni. Tengok ini dah keluar kan. Jadi bila dia save as a picture, dia akan ada tempat putih di tepi ni. So like this one is extended out already kan. You kena tolak supaya dia masuk ke dalam. Make sure everything within the blue box yang saya tunjuk sini. Di sini nampak memang tak keluar kan. But then this box memang keluar. Tengok, you kena
betul?
You kena push dia masuk. Supaya bila kamu select macam ni, you tengok tak ada yang keluar.
Oh,
okay. Barulah kamu right click save as picture.
Okay.
When you save as picture, you save it into the site. So in my site here, inilah semua gambar-gambar yang saya save tadi.
Oh, I see.
Jadi bila saya nak cari gambar ni, terus saya datang sini cari sajalah. Okay, so the design can be from Canva, tapi I rasa Canva a bit troublesome lah. You tukar-tukar sikit kena download lagi, tukar-tukar sikit kena download. It's a bit troublesome. So I would rather do it here. When I started off, I guna good Canva tau. Tapi bila I nak adjust the text tu, I kena pergi download sekali lagi. So over here, I just adjust right click save as, I overwrite, then I upload again. Itu je.
So easy from PowerPoint ni, right?
PowerPoint senang lah. Gambar-gambar ni saya ambil daripada PNG Wing. You know what is PNG Wing?
PNG Wing.
Di dulu ah, saya tolong cari sikit ah. PNG Wing ada tak? Oh, tak ada. Okay, so there is this thing called pngwing.com. PNG Wing. So
PNG Wing.
Yeah, I type here people. Dia akan tolong carikan gambar-gambar people lah. So these are all the people. Oh. Tapi dia tak ada background tau.
Oh, it's like clip art, is it?
This is not clip art, this is real picture what? Real people what?
Oh, okay. Other but what I'm saying is that it's come with transparent background, right?
Yes. So when you put this folder in into your designer, yep, it will be without the background lah. You tak perlu cari jalan untuk betul. Oh.
Wah, betul. Saya fikir mana dia orang dapat gambar lawa-lawa ni kan.
I pergi Google siap clean people transparent. People clip art contohlah kan.
You cari yang Google tu punya tak cantik.
Memang pun.
Low resolution. This is all high resolution picture.
Oh, high resolution High resolution.
Lepas tu, ada satu lagi adalah Unsplash lah. I rasa semua tahu kan Unsplash. Unsplash is a picture but it comes with the background. So
Unsplash.
This one, it comes with the background. Nampak?
Oh, so you choose either you want PNG.
Tengok gambar ni selalu kita nampak dalam website kan?
Betul.
Nah, dari sini lah.
So this one no trademark on lah. Can use it anytime lah.
You download saja. Tapi bila you download, katakan you nak gambar ni, dia akan suruh kamu say thanks to this person.
So you just key.
You just there photo. By who? On this one, you just give this one. So you copy this, you put it underneath lah, in your site ke or whatever lah. Tapi kalau you tak letak pun tak apa. They not going to what lah, but it's good lah. You apa? You appreciate them giving you the picture for free lah. All these are high resolution tau. Dia bukan alang-alang gambar yang diambil daripada telefon. Ini all this high resolution image. Very nice picture.
Yeah, agree.
So if you look for background. Nampak background.
Wow.
Eh, cantik semua.
Wow.
Jadi orang letak dekat belakang apa? Zoom ni selalunya.
So this tu lah. Yang ini you nak design. Design memang saya selalu ambil gambar dari sini lah. Alright. So let's just say I'm looking for computer. Sekarang I pergi atas ni, search apa dia computer. Dia akan cari semua gambar komputer untuk saya.
Oh, no wonder sebenarnya. I punya pening nak cari dekat Google no. Google image. Ada. Memang bagus ya kena Kevin ni benda aku tahu.
These are the resources that you're going to do. Tadi kita cuma belajar macam mana nak buat. So nak buat website, tapi sekarang mana nak dapat resources tu supaya dia nampak cantik? That's so, the thing that I want you all to know as well.
So this site Google, we have to know a lot of other things how to put in info.
Tengok mana nak dapat gambar-gambar macam ni.
Betul.
Sekarang you know lah. It's all coming from there lah, see.
Okay, get it.
How to get the picture like this without the background. How to get the book like this without the background.
Yeah, you're right. Susah.
Macam ni, macam mana you nak tambah macam ni? How? So it's like you need to know where to get it lah. Nampak? Okay, tengok jedah ini.
Itulah, nice. Ni you punya apa, from zero to hero.
Nice.
Okay, so you just go through all this website that can help you to do your resources lah. Okay, satu lagi yang saya nak tunjuk ah, di dalam site ni ya. Katakanlah saya tambah lagi satu site. Actually I have I think.
Ni okay. Buat sub page ke apa page semua ni?
Saya semua page saja, saya tak buat sub page. Itu sebabnya saya punya link tu tak ada drop down, saya tak nak drop down.
Now, this is susah is it kalau drop down?
I design this genially. Dalam genially tau. Then you can embed it in here.
Okay. But you design first like.
Ini adalah daripada Genially.
Dia ada template siap-siap dah Genially. Genially banyak dia punya apa template yang menarik kan?
Betul. I tak ada masa nak pergi design sendiri. So I pun ambil saja. Lepas tu I testing ni. So this
banyak is option dia sebab I pun tengah play around with Genially, try to figure out how to use it.
Genially.
So, the my one. So ada juga kat sini, you know. So this is the one that I have designed. Not design lah, I guna lah dia punya template tu. So after that lah, I just copy the embedded code. Okay, so I want to take this one and put it inside the Google site ya. So I pun pergi ke this way is that
share.
Dalam share ni atas tu, okay.
Let me take
this one away ya. Ni insert, nampak insert. Ini dia punya code. So I pun ambil iframe ni. You cubalah mana satu boleh guna lah. You ambil sahaja.
Copy lah.
You masuk ke dalam sini kan, kat sini.
Copy lah is it?
Tak. Ni tengok lah. Atas ni dalam insert.
Ada.
Ada embed.
Oh.
Then you go to this embed code, you paste.
Yang panjang-panjang tu.
Yang panjang-panjang tadi tu. So okay. Over here, you see I make a copy ya, iframe ah. Lepas tu I pergi ke sini, I paste.
Oh ya, betul lah.
Insert. You tunggu dia keluar lah. Yang ini.
Okay, I tengah fikir macam mana nak share yang Jumanli apa this Genially punya game ni kan.
This is called side. Embed lah. You kena embed the iframe. Kalau you dapat cari iframe dia, then can really.
Okay.
Tapi bukan semua game boleh tau. Maksud saya bukan semua website boleh tau. Genially boleh. Setahu saya Miro tak boleh. Entahlah, mungkin I tak tahu macam mana buat lah. I can't find where is that button, you know, like
dekat me. Dekat PowerPoint ada ke yang apa embed dia ni?
I rasa tak ada lah. Tengok kat sini, sebenarnya I belum explore lah. Tapi I don't know, I tak jumpa. Ini bukan saya punya Miro. So I cannot, I don't have Miro actually, I just guna orang punya. Tapi generally dia kan bila kita tekan share dia ada keluar. So I was like, oh okay, now I try this lah, I copy this and put it inside lah.
So? Dia friendly jugalah generally ni. And then there's a lot of fun stuff inside there.
And you know the different or not, Uni, kalau kita embed atau kita put insert?
No, don't understand the difference.
You don't know what's the difference, huh?
No.
Okay, because I embed my generally inside here, right? Okay, when I publish this, now this one is not shown on the navigation. Return. I should just go because I didn't make any changes, ma. I should just go in here.
View public site.
Okay. Okay, so this is the site kan? Bila saya suruh student, okay, student go to this site under the CEM Design No Games, click. Dia boleh main kat sini. Dia tak perlu masuk ke Genially.
Kalau insert? Kalau insert?
Kalau insert, dia boleh tengok gambar je lah.
Oh, insert is still. It's still picture.
Yeah, dia tak boleh main. Tengok lah. Saya klik. Okay, I press this one. Okay, stop. Okay, two. Okay, jalan. Dua jalan. Okay, sekarang. Siapa pula? Superman. Click.
So, the can the participant control?
One, two, three, four. Yeah, they are the one who come to this side.
But can you see the screen?
Yes, if I give you the side lah.
If you bagi dia link untuk dia orang masuk tu, and then you watch from your screen lah, macam biasa yang you buat Mentimeter
I see. Dia macam Mentimeter. That means I can see what they are doing. That four person there.
Macam Calvin share
contoh sekarang, kata saya share screen ini, okay? When you all move, then move lah.
Then you will watch. You be like watching live and commenting lah.
Kalau tak salah saya lah, I pernah cuba, boleh.
Generally like Mentimeter lah.
No, generally it's not Mentimeter. Tak sama. Generally it's just a presentation application online. But there are a lot of interaction feature there.
Betul. Generally memang there's a lot of dia build on interactivity. Interactivity. Kalau macam Mentimeter tu lain, dia quizzes, dia nak buat quiz ataupun yang buat poll, that's the one lah. Tapi generally banyak game-game dia, you explore je lah.
Okay, this is what I do. I can also give them this, you know, ke bawah ni. This link. This means share kan? So when I click here, I click this, I can actually share to them the code.
Kau you share dengan kita orang dekat dalam apa Zoom sekarang ni, apa jadi?
Copy. Mana check?
But I think Uni nak try. Okay, let's try Uni.
Okay, I click the okay. I'm inside there now. Okay. Accept all cookies ah. Okay. Set of cookies. So do I register or not?
No need.
I just start. Okay. Yeah, I start. I'm there already. I am there, but I don't know where I am. Which one? Am I Superman or Spider-Man? Or who? Who I am? I choose myself, okay. Is it?
So I am this one. Apa? I am this particular person. Don't know who is this.
You click macam
mana? Oh, ni kata mereka.
What I'm trying to tell you guys, you can share that to other people and they play. But for that share, I need to be in the Genially as well in order to play together with you guys. Itu kita main kat Genially.
So okay. Sekarang ni kalau let's say nak kita orang masuk, so then if let's say that we play, would you be able to see? Yeah. Cuba let's say.
But the problem is who I am.
Katakanlah you sebab dia ada Captain America.
But I don't know.
Okay, just choose one lah.
Just dia ke klik kita klik sana kalau kita choose.
Just click start.
Ayah dah klik start lah.
Okay, then you just roll dice kat tepi tu.
I roll. Okay, ada roll. Dapat 5.
Okay, then you tarik lah, you jalan lah. 5 step.
So siapa, I macam mana nak jalan lah. I dah click start tapi tak tahu mana tu.
Okay, macam sekarang ni so mine is 2. So 1, 2.
Tak gerak pun. Sekejap. Tak faham. Sekejap I still tengah mencari-cari lagi.
Okay, you click dulu. You click dekat apa? The player tu.
Okay guys, I start the game again lah. Okay, you all stop it first.
Okay. Alamak, apalah aku buat.
You click again.
Okay, wait. I cancel first, is it? Alamak.
Click the new link. Okay.
Kejap. Okay, tell you what. Okay, let's do all over again. The new link, ah.
Dah keluar, dah masuk balik sekarang ni.
Okay, I dah masuk balik. Okay, I'm there now. Okay, I start, ah. I click start, kan? Okay, I click start. Okay, I already click start. So, then what next I supposed to do? Let me know.
Okay, let's say now I click. Okay, mine is...
before, tapi I sudah lupa macam mana nak main dengan group.
Kan?
I play before. Memang I main dengan a few people before. So dia jadi. Tapi I cannot remember now how I play it.
Sebab yang ni macam individual C, individual board kan?
I'm looking at individual now. There is something that you can play together. Kan?
I boleh tarik semua orang lah.
Memang boleh.
Memang boleh.
Oh, boh, aku tahu.
So that's one thing about generally, you know, that's when I was looking at it, I fikir macam mana, you know, that only, how did you restrict? Maksudnya, you tak boleh move other people, you cannot disturb other people, kan? Tapi bila, tak jumpa lagi cara dia macam mana.
Kena explore lah ini. Tapi I just want to tell you all that if you have a website, there ada embed code, you boleh letak dalam site.
Okay.
Contoh, you punya YouTube video. YouTube video pun ada embed code kan, you letak. Jadi dia akan embed ke dalam ni. So this one generally we take to another session lah.
Yep. Nanti kena explore lagi sebabnya kalau kita nak play that one, we really need to know how to go about with it lah.
Betul.
Sebabnya dia macam, I know if you imagine kalau you nak main ramai and then lepas tu everybody pull everybody punya, mampus.
Mampus. Betul.
But I already played once before. Boleh tau. But I do not know now why cannot.
Tak ingat macam mana. Kena explore lah, kena explore betul-betul lah.
Okay, so yeah, I just want to tell you that you can do the
embed.
This is embed. The difference is that these people can actually play directly in your site and don't have to go externally to generally to play.
So at least here, macam everything is under one stop center lah.
Can we do Mentimeter here also? I mean, just curious, asking question.
You can.
Can we insert Mentimeter?
Okay. Mentimeter. Tahu saya tak ada embed code.
Oh, tak ada embed code.
Okay. Kena control from there code.
Dah lama tak guna Mentimeter.
Tak ada kan? Tak tahu embed code kat mana pun.
Tak tahu masuk mungkin.
Tiga dot tu, tiga dot kan ada?
Okay, share. Ada ke embed code?
Link je lah. Dia ada link je.
Link aja.
Don't have
link
so,
presentation link sharing? Tu? Oh, ada lah.
Ada lah.
Ya, cuba.
Oh, okay, embed code. Kita letak.
Let's try. Exciting ni. Oh boy, aku yang excited. Next. Insert lah. Zoom.
Boleh lah tu. Kalau tak boleh, dia terus keluar error tadi.
Oh. Wow. All in one. Tak payahlah keluar masuk kan? Betul tak?
Betul. But tapi, the host still need to play from there lah.
Betul, the host still can activate the Mentimeters.
So that one is only for viewer.
Yep.
Betul.
So you still kena bagi link dekat the participant untuk dia orang masuk.
Mereka pergi your site.
Masuk code tu lah.
So like this one. Sekarang I reset.
Let's play.
Okay. So I think in my site, dia akan update lah.
Ya. Automatic oh.
So dia orang kena masuk dalam code dalam the link tu lah kan. It looks like you're trying to be repaged in more than one window. Please close other window with the same quiz and refresh. Saya kena marah lagi.
Oh, garang. Garang lah perempuan ni. Mesti perempuan. Jahat lagi. Mana dia?
Mana?
Boleh tak?
Kat bawah tu kot rasa ni.
Are we rolling lagi?
Dia macam tak boleh.
Have to try out lah. I pun tak pernah buat Mentimeter ni.
Apa dia bang? Ha? Ada. Tu ada.
Deh, okay bang. Kan? So student who actually follow your course, you share screen here. You boleh tunjuk video, you boleh tunjuk ni. Lepas tu you kata, okay, let's do the quiz.
When they say waiting for player, that means I have to put in the chat there the link to the Mentimeter, is it?
No.
Ask them to go into, on the top here tu, ada go to
Mentimeter.com
and use that code. Let's try now.
I just nak try juga, eh. I jenis suka try, boleh rasa punya, sekejap, eh.
Very, very kinesthetic.
Kan? Sangat susah tau, okay?
Very, very visual and kinesthetic.
Dah Mentimeter, I nak masuk ni. Lambatnya ni, Robby, Tuhan tu. So slow. Sekejap, internet I lambat, eh. Okay, so I masuk code. Mana code?
3, 3, 6, 7, 9, 5.
Aku tak boleh masuk, ah. Sekejap. Okay, join presentation. Salah masuk. Sekejap, eh. Apa nombor dia? 336?
3, 3, 6, 7, 6, 8, 5.
Okay. Submit. Okay, I'm in now. Connected. Okay.
Bunny, Kola.
Join quiz. Yes, Kola. Join quiz. Get ready to play uni. Yes, I'm waiting. Question 1 or 5. So I'm waiting. Dia tak gerak. Okay, now answer fast to get more point. Okay. You can handle multiple user edit. Okay, 2, 1, start. Okay, can you, what is this? Share workbook, protect workbook. Okay lah, can lah, I try. Okay, I dah submit tadi. Contoh lah, loading result. Okay, correct answer. I tak tahu apa je.
You look at my screen. I tengah share ni kan? Are you looking?
Yep.
So now we have Uni the winner lah.
Sebab dia seorang je. Benar tanpa pertanding.
But you are controlling over there, Kevin. You're controlling your Mentimeter.
I'm controlling using the site.
You're at the site Google now.
The launcher has to be from the
Mentimeter.
Okay. Tapi I am actually controlling one slide after another from here, from my site.
Oh, so I don't have to go to Mentimeter. I just launch the Mentimeter. I see. Okay, now question 2 or 5. I'm waiting. Very interesting. Answer fast to get more points. Same thing, same screen. Okay. Which are following the auditing tool? Okay. Loom, I think so that one lah. Okay. Hantam je. Hey, salah.
Not every day Sunday.
Today Saturday tau. Eh, Kevin, after hours is 6 p.m. right?
Huh?
Yeah, ada. You joining or not? The 6 p.m. one, the communication queen.
Communication queen lah. The Sarah, no, Sarah lah. Sarah
Knight. 6 p.m. you join.
Itu perempuan saja.
Is it? I didn't even read. I just read 6 queen only. That's it.
Siapa tu?
Petang ni ada apa? What you call that? Communication queen. She's a speaker from what? From which country? Ah? From where? Ah?
From Sweden.
Ah,
siapa organize?
Dia yang organize. You nak, kalau you nak boleh register juga. Walaupun Uni tak jawab, tapi dia juga the leader.
So dia maksudnya dia continue. Did you have to kind of click kat mana-mana ke?
I boleh terus control dari sini kalau I tak nak pergi sana. Tengok, boleh juga.
Oh.
But everything control from here.
Oh, sebab ada embed code dah.
Ada embed code.
Okay.
Kena testing lah ni. I kena panggil. I kena testing. Testing kan.
So when you build this site, sebagai satu course material. Tadi you tak bagi buku dan sebagainya. Semua content ada kat sini dan quiz pun ada kat sini. Jadi you tak perlu print. Okay. Now, selepas you punya sesi 1 hour or 30 minutes of your session, you just embed the video here. Then they can come back and review and relearn lah. That's what I think is good for lah, you know.
Okay, can restrict lah after let's say for certain time you decided okay no longer bagi access, you boleh remove the access kah? Tak boleh takut.
You can change the name lah supaya tak masuk lah. Tapi kalau student yang telah belajar tu, biarlah dia. Okay. Oh, this is one thing you can also do. Okay, let me just share again. Yeah, share again. Ini adalah site dia kan tadi. So this three dot, okay. This one is for let's just say Kelvin Ng Batch 1. I can duplicate the site.
Mm-hmm.
And okay. I name it as Kelvin Ng Batch 2. Jadi bila I duplicate, dia punya code dah berbeza.
So bila you share that, let's say the second batch tu, you share dengan dia orang, they only can see the second batch punya page sajalah. Ataupun betul. Dia boleh tengok lain page lagi.
Tak boleh.
Okay.
So you can design one yang generic punya, yang asal punya, then you duplicate for cohort one. Then you go for the original one, you duplicate, then you put it as cohort 2.
Okay, then you share that link so people, only those in cohort whatever dapat lah. Okay. Alright. Because sometimes kan certain program kan very client kan kadang-kadang very particular sikit kan, you know, ataupun you tak mention lah, you tak nak training provider rasa-rasa kenapa semua orang boleh tengok training yang kita buat, takut nanti ada perbalahan. Yalah, sebab kita seorang run berbagai-bagai training provider. same content pula tu.
Betul.
So okay lah, itu sahaja perkongsian saya hari ini.
Thank you so much.
I kena main dulu sampai I pening, I ada soalan, then masa tu you tengok. Kevin, why like that?
Betul, kita biasa, we are very good in exploring, so. Right?